Hey guys, this is Dan Wolwacker, Coal Cracker Bushcraft. So today I'm coming out and I'm going to work on making a basket out of all natural materials. Specifically, I'm going to use tulip poplar bark to do that. So I have a tulip poplar tree right behind me, and I looked around a little bit. I found something that was on the smoother side and something that was around the size of the basket I want. And I'm looking for something that's about the width of my back. So what you need to take into consideration is the way we're going to cut this, okay? One wrap around this whole thing is going to be one side of the basket. So I can't even wrap my hands around these trees. So you're looking at the basket's going to be about this wide when we are all done with this. So what you want to initially do is decide on, of course, the width of your basket and the length of your basket. So you want to look around the tree and make sure there's no areas of the tree that are scarred real bad or already cracked or maybe rotted, because you want a good sheet of bark to start this process. So how are we going to cut this and how are we going to get off the tree? I'm going to first go through the process and then we'll get a little bit of footage of me actually working on it. So what we're going to do is we want to take this whole piece right off the tree, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to cut this all the way around with our knife and all the way around on the bottom, and that's going to be our length, okay? And then we're going to cut down the tree and we're going to start to work with our fingers, getting our hands inside and working back all the way around. So it's a slow process, but it can be done, and you're just going to keep working it until you have that whole sheet peeled off. Once that's peeled off, of course, then we can start to cut it and fold into what we need. Okay guys, the two tools that I'm going to be using today is just, of course, my knife and my Bocco. Now you can do this with, of course, a sharp piece of flint. It's just going to take a lot longer if you wanted to go the all natural route. What I'm going to do basically to start is I'm just going to give myself some marking points of where I want to make this basket. Okay. So, like I said, we're looking at the length that's going to actually fold over on itself, as you're going to see. So, if I want my basket about this long, then we're looking at somewhere up in here. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to take my time and work around this whole tree, just like this, just to get down to the wood. Now this time of the year, right now, is mid-May, so this is probably one of the better times to do this, because that's the sap, again, is still flowing, everything's real wet, and it's going to peel off better. If you try to do something like this in the winter, it's not going to work out that well. We can touch all this stuff up if it's a little bit crooked or if it's a little bit messy once we first start it going. Okay, so I have my top cut and my bottom cut done. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to score a line straight down to match up from my top line all the way down to my bottom line. I'm just going to take my time, just keep cutting in, make sure I'm getting deep enough with this. It might take a little bit. So I'm going to continue this line all the way down to the bottom, and then we'll start separating the bark from the tree. Okay guys, so what we're working on now is I started to take the tip of my knife and I'm starting to work the bark away from the tree. Now you need to be careful, of course, you don't want to stab yourself with your knife. But you're just getting your knife in And if you can hear, that bark's starting to peel away nicely. Okay. You just gotta check what you're doing. Work it down. You see, I'm using my fingers. And a lot of this is just taking your time. If something seems like it's not cut through enough, then back to the drawing board and get your saw out or get your knife out or your stone. So I can see coming up in here a little bit, I didn't cut deep enough. So I just made, I scored it a little bit deeper. Now I'm going to keep working down, guys, on here, as I am, to get one side. Just seems a little bit easier for me. But you can work on both sides if you'd want, initially. Whatever would work easier for yourself. Okay? Now, one thing is, you are going to kill this tree by doing this. So when you're picking a tree, of course, you want to pick something. We have a bunch of projects that me and my friends want to do with tulip poplar. So we're okay having a dead standing tree for a while. It'll dry out, can make some good bow drill sets, and then we can do some carving and some other projects in the future. Now, as you can see, it takes a little bit of muscle to do this. Okay, so if you start to get cramped up or anything, of course, you're working with these blades. Take 5 minutes. And relax. Okay? Just like I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna continue with this. We'll get some footage as we go. Let my hand, just from holding in there and tight, so tight, starting to get a little bit of cramping up. Drink some water. I'm gonna start working on this. We'll get some more footage as we go. So I have my cut done, and we have our top ring and bottom ring. And this is where you're gonna just get your hands in here and start to work this around. Okay? Just take your time. And you can feel this is absolutely soaking wet on the inside, which is what you want with this. Now, just gotta make sure as you go that everything's cut. This bottom ring is cut real good. So you just wanna take your time and make sure everything's coming out properly. The biggest part that you have to watch here is your top and bottom ring. You don't want your basket material to split out as you're going, okay? So what I'm gonna do now is continue to just work around the tree the way I am. I'm not gonna start to work this side. I just think it's easier rather than trying to get this restarted. It's like a roll of tape almost at this point. Keep my hand in there. Now, if you wanna look up here closely, tulip poplar, as we know, has branches and then they fall off. These little nodules that come out, okay, are extremely sharp. So when you're running your hands here, you need to be careful. You don't want to slice your hand on something like this because they are extremely sharp. So when you feel one, just work around it. The bark will pop off away from where that is. I'm going to try to show you guys in here if you can see how that is, okay? They're just pulling away. So we're going to continue to work this around, continuing to check my bottom pieces if I see anywhere that need to be trimmed. I'm going to get right in there, trim it, same for the top. Just working. Now don't get carried away again because you'll split out your top. Your rings aren't cut deep enough. So just keep your tools handy. Try to work from top to bottom, bottom to top. Just taking your time. And if you get in a sticky spot, then just saw a little bit more, cut a little bit more, and you'll be good. So, as I'm getting close to the end, you just need to be careful because you're starting to get a lot of weight of your bark with you. So you don't want to just start to pull and crack that down, okay? Just take your time, sure all your cuts are good. Top cut, bottom cut. Just keep working, take your time, like I said. Watching your top, watching your bottom. I know we're getting close. Move my gear out of the way. All right. And the last little bit hung up. You don't want to just pull it, you want to cut it. And we have our first sheet of material. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to take this back to camp, take a break for a little bit, and start the next part of this process. So stay tuned and we'll move forward. Here's a piece of bark that we peeled from the tree a bit earlier. What I'm actually going to do now is I only want my basket about this wide, okay? So I'm going to trim this down this way. So I'm going to measure in how wide I would want my basket. Of course, the length of this, we're going to flip over itself. So half of this is going to be the length of my basket. So the width of my basket, I'm going to measure on the inside about how far in I would want it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to score it and then just keep scoring it until I can split it out. And then we'll have two pieces here. We can make an extra basket out of that. So for now, what I'm gonna do is just work that down to get the width of my basket, and then we'll get back to you and show you the next step. Now that I have this cut to width, like I said, the length is gonna be half, basically, a little bit less than half, because the way we're gonna cut our bottom piece. So what you wanna do is you wanna find your dead center point. You can just use a stick, a piece of rope, anything like that. So you wanna find your center mark. Okay, and then you want to go about even. You're going to basically make an X here. Okay, you can either mark that or just sort of eyeball it. And then you want to make a football shape. You can either draw that on with a pencil or a pen, or of course you can use charcoal, or you can just sort of eyeball it. So once you have that basic shape in your mind, what you want to do, and I'm going to show you this as we go along. I know you can't see on camera right now what I'm actually going to be cutting. But we're going to be cutting a football shape, okay, out of this. Now, you don't want to cut through the inner bark. You just want to score the outer bark. And then we're going to bend this using our knee. Just slowly, we're going to bend this container together to make the sides touch. All right. So what we want to do is we're going to just start, take our knife, and just lightly score our outer bark. Just like that. Same on the other side. Okay, so our knife in a safe place. We have this all scored. Now what we're gonna do, you're gonna have to use your knife a little bit for this, and you're just gonna have to take your time. What you wanna do is you're gonna start to bend this over your knee a little bit, okay? And what's gonna start to happen as you do this, you're gonna see the outer bark is gonna start to open up, and the inner bark's gonna start to get exposed. Now, like I said, you might have to touch this up as you go with your knife, but you don't want to go too deep with this. You just want to get that outer bark to separate a little bit. So I'm actually going to have the camera come in a little bit closer and start to show you guys what this is going to start to look like. So as I work this over my knee, you can see we're starting to get a bend there, okay? And I'm just going to work one side at a time. I'm going to go a little bit further in and start to work that, little bit further. As you can see, it's starting to open up. Now right in here, you could tell, it's a little bit of a tough spot. So all I want to do is just get my knife and just open it up a little bit more. Nothing too tough. Just like that. So I'm going to do the same on this side, okay? And then our basket's going to start to get in a little bit, close in a little bit more. And then we're going to be getting close to finalizing this, putting finishing touches on it. My basket's starting to close up, okay? My sides are getting tighter together. And that would be the time, of course, if I didn't measure perfectly, which we're off a little bit, no problem at all. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna trim this up to even out the top, okay? Now, of course, you wouldn't need to do this, but it's gonna make the basket look a little bit nicer once I'm all done. So, this is where I'm at right now with it, okay? I can even trim this down if I would want to, have it a little bit shorter, but I wanted a taller basket to be able to put some larger items in, maybe some trapping tools or something like that. So I'm gonna trim this top up to even it out, and then I'm gonna go out. I gotta get some more supplies, and I'll bring them back, and we will start to put the finishing touches on our bark basket. Okay guys, so what I've done now is I collected, this is just a birch sapling that I collected. It's green. It was, and I took all the bark off, and I'm just starting to work this over my knee. Basically what we're gonna do with this is I'm gonna keep working this until I can make a circle out of this the same size as the top of my basket that I just made, and this is gonna be my top hoop. And then what I'm gonna do from there is I'm gonna lash this top hoop for some stability around the outside of the basket, and then I'm gonna lace it with some type of cordage. Now I made some Tulip Poplar 2-ply reverse wrap cordage that I'm actually gonna tie this together once I get my circle and force this over the top of my basket. And then baskets, they're still pushing outward because they're not dried yet. So I want that, because once I make my circle, I'll slide that in, the basket will push out, and then I can go ahead, make my holes, lash it on, and we have a nice stable top on that basket. There's a couple different ways you can do this, but today, I'm just gonna go with a small green sapling to do that. So I'm gonna keep working this for a while until I get it flexible enough to make a full complete circle. And then I'm gonna go get some natural cordage or some type of material to lash it on. Okay guys, so I made my circle and I just kept looking basically at my basket so far, how I have it set up. And then I just used some natural cordage from the inner bark of the Tulip Poplar that I had left just to make some cordage to hold it. Now as this dries, of course, it's gonna hold this shape. So I'm actually going to get some more inner bark and make a real long strand of cordage and do this whole inside. And that's basically just for looks. That's not gonna hurt anything to keep it just like this. But I'm gonna just adjust that so it looks a little bit better. Next, I'm gonna cut this off and I'm gonna have my initial hoop for the top of my basket. Next, I'm gonna either have to get some type of root or make more cordage to actually lace this on the top of my basket. And then I'm gonna decide if I wanna lace down the sides of my basket depending on how they hold together. Which I think at this point I'm not gonna need to do that. We're gonna see as the basket dries. I've seen a couple that they actually really hold well together once this top loop gets on. So I'm gonna look at it once we get this on and I get it laced up. So I'm gonna go out, get some more materials, and then pick up from there. All right guys, so I put my hoop on the top of my basket. And as you can see, I just used some cordage that I made from the inner bark of Tulip Poplar. And then this is some spruce root from a sapling. So I dug up some more roots. And basically what I'm gonna do, as you can see here, I'm just gonna punch a hole and I'm just gonna start to wind this around just like that, okay? So it's a pretty straightforward process. Now, as you can see, I was using different knives today, and that's for no other reason than I had them with me today. But having all different types of tools is gonna help during this project. But of course you can do just with the knife. If you didn't have a knife, you can make somewhat of a hand drill kit. And then what you would do with that is, you can actually just burn in your holes, okay? So what I'm gonna do is take my root, and I rinsed this off. I got all the dirt off and the little stuff off and everything. Just take my time so I don't break it. And start to work that through. Just going to turn it. And you can make this however you would want, as far as for design, but for utility, just real straightforward process. Not looking at anything too intensive here. Put my root in. And that's letting me start to attach the top on, okay? So I'm gonna work the rest of the way around with this. Once I get around, if I have enough, which it looks like I'm going to, I may use this other side and might be close, but I might make an X type design. So I'll show you guys that as I progress along, but this is gonna secure my top. Once my top is secured, then of course you can see my sides. I can do the same thing with roots down the side, or I can also, as this dries, I can get some pine pitch or something like that and seal up these sides if I would need it. But I think for now, we're just gonna finish up the top and I'm gonna leave the basket as is till I decide further where I wanna go. But I'll show you some progress as we progress here forward. Okay guys, so as you can see, I just looped it around the top and just kept weaving it back and forth. So that's really gonna secure this up. Everything's gonna dry, it's gonna keep it good and tight. Now for the sides, right now I'm just gonna leave this container as is, okay? I'm gonna think about how I wanna put some straps on here so I can carry it somewhat like a pack basket. And it's not gonna be too hard if I need to lace up these sides, which like I said, I'm gonna think about that, what I ultimately wanna do with that and how I wanna do it. So for now, we're just gonna let it as is for a basket. So not too tough of a project. A little bit time consuming, but it is enjoyable. So thanks for joining me for this video. I hope you enjoyed making a basket out of bark. Stay tuned for more videos. This was Dan Wowak with Coal Cracker Bushcraft. I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks, guys.